region. In this region means the radio frequency region. NMR spectrum means here the reversal of spin of nucleus occurs, and in ESR spectrum we see the spin reversal of electron occurs. The law governing the absorption of radiation. The law of absorption of radiation was discovered by J. H. Lambert in 1760, and it is referred to as Lambert's law. Now you see that radiation incident upon a system may be reflected, refracted, transmitted, and scatter or absorb. Okay, there are several probabilities. Now we only consider the absorption and transmission of light. Okay. Now the Lambert's law is stated as when monochromatic light passes through a transparent medium, the rate of decrease of intensity of radiation with the thickness of the medium is proportional to the intensity of radiation falling over it. Okay. Now the mathematical expression of Lambert's law is log I0 by IT equals to K into L. This is the ultimate expression for the integrated form of Lambert's law. Now we started. You see, minus dIdl is proportional to I, where I is the intensity of the radiation, okay? And dI is the decrease in intensity, and dL is the thickness of the medium. We have stated that minus dIdl, since we have said that the decrease in intensity of radiation with the thickness of the medium, that is dL, is proportional to the intensity of radiation falling over it. That is, minus dIdl is proportional to I, okay? Now, dI by I equals to minus K into dL. Okay. Now, you integrate. Ln I equals to minus KL plus IC, where IC is the integration constant. Now, we evaluate the integration constant. When L is 0, I equals to I0, where I0 is the original intensity of the DSC. Original intensity of radiation. I0 equals to actually IA plus IT, where IA is the absorbed intensity of absorbed light, and IT is the intensity of transmitted light. I0 is the total intensity, original intensity. IT is the intensity of transmitted light. Okay. So when L equals to 0, I is I0. Thus, you see IC equals to ln I0. And put this value, put the value of integration constant in the above equation, you will get ln I equals to ln I0 minus KL. Ln I equals to ln I0 minus KL. But this I in the LA case is actually IT. Okay, the intensity of transmitted light. So ln IT equals to ln I0 minus KL. And this K is the absorption coefficient. This K is the proportionality constant, and it is termed as absorption coefficient. Okay. Now log I0 by IT or log IT by I0 equals to minus K divided by 2.303 into L. This K by 2.303 is designated as K. This is the capital K. It is the small K, this is the capital K. And this K is termed as absorptivity or extinction coefficient. And log I0 by IT is termed as optical density or absorbance or extinction. Okay. And this K is termed as, or is defined as, the reciprocal of thickness. Since you see that when IT equals to I0 by 10, and IT equals to I0 by 10, that is the intensity of transmitted light is 1/10 of its original intensity, then you have K equals to 1 by L. So, absorptivity is defined as the reciprocal of thickness when the intensity of transmitted light is 1/10 of its original intensity. Yes? So, its unit is centimeter inverse or meter inverse in CGS and SI system. Now, the effect of concentration was studied by A. Beer in 1852. Now, see the gap, 1760 and 1852. And the combined law is termed as Lambert-Pierce law. If the chemical form of the absorbing species means the light absorbing species. Okay. If the chemical form of the light absorbing species does not change with concentration, then under such condition, Lambert-Pierce law will be valid. Okay. The chemical form may change by complex formation, by dissociation, by association, or anything else. Okay. So, if the chemical form of the absorbing species does not change with concentration, then only Lambert-Pierce law will be valid. And Lambert-Pierce law will be stated as, when a monochromatic light passes through a transparent medium, the rate of decrease of intensity of radiation with the thickness of the medium is proportional to the intensity of radiation falling on it and also to the concentration of the light absorbing species. In Lambert's law, we have seen that minus dI dl is proportional to I, but from Lambert-Pierce's law, we have minus dI dl is proportional to I, and also minus dI dl is proportional to C, where C is the concentration of the light absorbing species. Okay. So now, minus dI dl is equal to epsilon base into I into C. This epsilon base is the proportionality constant. Okay. So, Bi by I equals to minus epsilon base into C into L. And Bi by I equals to this. Now, if you integrate, you have ln I equals to minus epsilon base into C into L plus IC. IC is the integration constant. Now you have to evaluate the value of IC. When L equals to 0, IC equals to I0. And you have ln I equals to ln I0 minus epsilon base into C into L. L is the thickness of the medium. Medium means the transparent medium. Okay. So ln IT by I0 equals to minus epsilon base into C into L. Or log IT by I0 equals to minus epsilon into L into C. Now this epsilon is actually epsilon base divided by 2.30. And this epsilon is actually termed as molar extinction coefficient or molar absorptivity or molar adsorption coefficient. So the Lambert-Pierce law is log I0 by IT equals to epsilon into C into L. This is the mathematical expression. And like I said, my IP already I said is defined as optical density. Okay. And epsilon is defined as the reciprocal of thickness. Since if P equals to 1 and if L equals to 1, then epsilon equals to log I0 by IT. And if IT equals to I0 by 10, then epsilon is equal to 1 by L. So, epsilon is defined as the reciprocal of thickness, that is 1 by L, of 1 molar solution. We have taken C equals to 1 molar, which reduces the intensity of incident radiation to 1/10 of its original value. That is IT equals to I0 by 10. The intensity of incident light is 1/10 of its original value, IT equals to I0 by 10. And its unit is liter mole inverse centimeters. And epsilon depends on the nature of the solute. Okay. And it also depends on the nature of the solvent. So you see that epsilon depends on the nature of solute and also in a particular form. Since I have already said that Lambert-Beer's law will be valid if the chemical form of the absorbing species does not change with concentration. Okay, you know that with dilution, dichromate is converted to chromate. That is, CH2 minus is converted to CrO2 minus. So dilution changes the chemical form. That is, dichromate is converted to chromate. Or association, dissociation, complex formation, etc. So epsilon depends on nature of the solute, nature of solvent, and the nature of the radiation. That is intensity of radiation. Okay. And to some extent on the temperature. This is the validity of Lambert-Beer's law, already I have said. Now the laws of photochemistry. There are two basic laws of photochemistry. Okay. First law of photochemistry and second law of photochemistry. First law of photochemistry is termed as Rochas and Dipperson. And it is termed as, it is represented as only those radiations that are absorbed by the system are effective in producing a chemical change. That is, the molecule A absorbs UV or visible radiation and it becomes excited and undergoes into a chemical change. That is, gives the photon. This is the process and repulsion. But the absorbed light may be converted to the kinetic energy of the absorbing molecule. Since absorption of radiation always does not lead to the chemical change, the absorbed light may be converted to the kinetic energy of the reacting molecule, okay, and may be exchanged with some other molecule by collision as kinetic energy, or may be re-emitted by fluorescence or phosphorescence. These are all, that is, the reaction and fluorescence, phosphorescence all together are termed as photochemical change. So now the Grothers-Dipper law should be restated as only those radiations that are absorbed by the reacting system are effective in producing a photochemical change. This chemical change term should be replaced by photochemical change. Since I have already said that absorption of radiation always does not lead to a chemical change, okay, reactions may occur or the absorbed energy may be converted to the kinetic energy of the absorbing molecule, or the absorbed energy may be re-emitted to fluorescence, phosphorescence, these spectroscopic phenomena. All these mean the reaction, that is the chemical change, or the spectroscopic phenomena, fluorescence, phosphorescence are termed as photochemical change. And chemical change term should be replaced by photochemical change. So the restatement is only those radiations that are absorbed by the system are effective in producing a photochemical change. Okay. Now the second law of photochemistry. Second law of photochemistry is also termed as Stark-Einstein's law. Second law of photochemistry was stated by Stark, and the thermodynamic derivation was proposed by Einstein and is termed as Stark-Einstein's law or the law of photochemical equivalence. And the statement is